Hi Scorpio, welcome to Omkara Tarot and another session of You and Yours. So this is you and the person who is affecting your energy the most at this time and what you need to know how to navigate this energy. So these are not typically love readings, but of course a love interest could show through as well if that's what you know is on your mind right now. Though I have just uploaded love readings, and those are only, nobody else is allowed. Only you and your love interest, okay? So if you're more interested in those, I'll leave a link at the end of this video. You could go check those out as well. So Scorpio, let's begin your reading. And also know, Scorpio, these readings are general collective, okay? So each and every reading is not going to resonate with each Scorpion out there. So don't try and make, you know, fit it into your life if you feel this is not for you. Maybe it's made for another Scorpio who needs to hear this message right now. So one side is going to be you, Scorpio, and the other side is going to be the person who's affecting your energy. And in the center will be your mutual energy and any advice if you can get some from spirit. Eight of Swords in reverse, bottom of the deck, which is great. Letting go of some stress and tension, it seems, Scorpio, this month. This is for the second week of June, actually. But, you know, time is fluid, right? So this could be something you're going through right now. Just been through it. Or could you know, this could be going to happen in the immediate future. So let's see, you have the Eight of Cups, the Ten of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, Seven of Pentacles, and the Sun. For your person, I have here the Chariot, Six of Pentacles in reverse, Eight of Wands, Ace of Swords, Four of Cups, and the Page of Wands. Okay, for your mutual energy, the Magician, wow, Nine of Wands, and the Ace of Cups. That is excellent to have in a mutual position here. Okay, so now let's just get into the reading and see what we need to know. There is someone, Scorpio, just give me a moment here. Okay, all right. Okay, so there's somebody here, Scorpio, this would be your person, let's say, and this is you. Somebody walked away from your life, okay? Somebody walked away from your life, probably there was, you know, they were going back and forth in their head about what to do, but there was somebody not happy in the household dynamic, because they have the King of Pentacles, which, you know, represents a house, a home where, you know, the children and parents and all that, but that's in reverse for them. So they kind of thought, they really gave it a big thought, and then they made a decision here, okay? They made a decision and they decided to walk away from this. Whoever this is for you, I don't know, could be your sister, brother, could be a parent, could be a wife, could be somebody who decided that, you know, it's time for me to walk away, and was not happy in a structured environment like a household, okay? Because Ten of Pentacles does signify that. And they made that decision after, they held on for as long as they could, I think. There was a lot of turbulence in their life. And they tried to hold it together. You see the wavy background, the sea, how turbulent this is. So they lived through this for quite a while, till they finally kind of made the decision and walked out. And because they were really stressed, okay, and they decided the only way to get, you know, get over their sleepless nights, their worrying, their stress, their tension, was maybe to go out there and have a new beginning for themselves, okay? I think they went out, took a new beginning and became single, and they wanted to prosper, or they have prospered on their own. So let's take a clarifier for this as well. Too many cards. Okay, this one still wanted to come out, so we'll take it, okay? So they looked out into the big world out there, and look at this guy, he has a globe in his hand and he's got his staff ready, and he's just looking out to see, you know, where should I now go, plant roots now, whole world is open to me, and where should I go? So I think that's the call they took. Okay, the page of Ace of Pentacles looks so much like this, the world that they're holding in this guy's hand. Both look so similar. It's almost like this, the same guy holding this, right? So they decided to plant their new life somewhere out, away from you. And they went on to become a single person, single and abundant on their own. Right now, I think they are in a place where they're taking stock of their life. Okay, even though from that one pentacle, they have, I think, maybe, you know, like a farmer does, sown many of these pentacles, from one to, I think now I can count seven here. And this person is taking stock as to, you know, what have I done in so much time? Even though they feel quite satisfied with the amount of progress they've made in their life, they don't look completely happy to me. Okay, the Sun is a card which, even in reverse, is not a bad card. But of course, a Sun upright would have been like, oh my God, this person is on seventh heaven and they've achieved it all and they've done it all. But this is in reverse for them. Okay, so they're not really completely happy, and they feel that they did make that decision. Okay, they did make they left all the confusion behind, but they probably had to work very hard. Okay, they have been in isolation for a long time, and they, you know, they're sitting alone and working on this, which is making them feel not that happy, maybe. Right? Maybe they're just lonely at the moment. So, Spirit, what is the Seven of Cups in reverse for them? They definitely don't look confused to me. They are very, they know what they want. They've got what they wanted, okay? They left the confusion behind. But somewhere they again, see, I've got the same card again for them. Nine of Pentacles, okay? The single happy person. Two of the same cards which represents them. So this is what they went out to achieve. This is what they have achieved, I think, right now. But somehow they're not really, really happy. Okay? I would say out of 100, 90% happy. But there's something missing from their life. I think they felt that they were in a very toxic relationship when they were in this relationship. They do realize that they've let it go, and maybe now they want to slowly move back to you, make some kind of an offer of coming back in some form or the other. Let's take a card for the Knight of Pentacles, Spirit. What is this Knight of Pentacles? What does this person want who's now become single and happy and achieved all their, whatever they wanted to do, and left all the sadness and the toxicity behind, yet they have this Knight of Pentacles? Yeah, they want to, you know, they want to put down these defenses now, okay? Maybe they just want to head back to a space where they are comfortable with you. They want to lower their defenses. Because initially this could have been like maybe a major separation, and now that they've achieved their self-respect and their pentacles and their happiness, they are looking back to see that at least the happy times that you all shared, maybe there is a chance to recapture some of that, and they don't want to have barriers between the two homes or two people or whatever. So they're trying to make some kind of small gestures towards, even though intuitively they know, okay, intuitively they know that there is no moving forward, intuitively they know that there is no going back to this relationship, right? So, but they still want to kind of, show some kind of friendship or care. Because there must have been love, right? There must have, whenever two people are together, everything is not bad. So there are some good memories also, some good times. So they feel, okay, now I'm established and I'm more confident, and maybe now I can recapture the friendship part of it. Let's see in Scorpio, your side, what are you thinking? Right. This card, I don't know from where it flipped out, but yes, they walked away, right? They walked away from, see these troubled waters that they were in here initially, all these wavy waters, troubled waters, same here. So they've managed to walk away from all that. So let's see your end. Where are you now, Scorpio? You want to charge ahead, right? You really want to move ahead to something, and you feel that yes, there was no equal give and take, or maybe things didn't pan out the way you wanted them to. But you also feel that, you know, even though you want to charge ahead, the other person is not giving you the amount that you want. Maybe you want equal partnership back, right? But this person is a bit strong, and you know, she knows her mind now. She's no longer wishy-washy, and she's no longer getting fooled by anything. And you're upset about the fact that maybe this person lays down the rules straight and says, hey, this much and no more. And you're also upset about the fact that they walked away from, you know, this dynamic. You want to communicate something to them, and you want to do it fast, and you want to be very clear about it. You really want to head towards this person with some strong communication, clear communication. You want to offer them something again, okay? But this is a card you both have, I think, yes. Okay, I've lost it here, right? So, Knight of Pentacles and Page of Pentacles. So, you both have something similar in mind that, hey, is it possible that, you know, we can come to some kind of a middle ground here? Very tentative and small ops, you know, small moves forward, but you want to be very clear about it too, right? You want to have this communication about it, that is there any chance that, you know, you will, and you're a little worried that if you offer this person an offer, will they reject it? You're not sure whether this person is going to accept your offer, and that's why I think you're a little hesitant about even offering it. Let's have a card for the Four of Cups spirit. You really want to rush forward, okay? Scorpio, you are in your zone, okay? You want to take that wand of yours and gallop towards this person. Okay, this is what you really want to do. It could be the other person, Scorpio. I don't know, maybe this person was you. So, but this person here really wants to communicate, wants to send in a message, maybe regarding children or something, because I have a Page of Wands and a Page of Pentacles here. And they want, they are a little afraid that this person may or may not accept their offer. Let's see, let's take one more card for the Four of Cups spirit. What is this Four of Cups for Scorpio? I think Scorpio, you're feeling a bit depressed right now. You're feeling a bit low, you're feeling a bit defeated, and you're really wishing for this, okay? You're really wishing for this, and you really want a chance to communicate that as fast as possible to this person. Have some clear communication, because you are really feeling miserable in this situation. You're not liking the fact that this person has moved away from you. So what is this Page of Wands spirit for Scorpio? What is this Page of Swords? Oh, sorry, Wands for Scorpio right now. You don't know, Scorpio, you don't know how to offer this love again. Maybe so much has happened in the past. There's so much of hurt, pain, and whatever has happened. You are unable to tell them, or you don't know how to communicate this to them. Right? You don't know how to offer your love anymore. So let's see in your mutual energies. These look very good to me. And there's a Magician and there is the Ace of Cups. Okay, so let's read this. Forget all this for the time being. Let's see, why do both people have the Magician? Both are trying to manifest something. So why is the Magician in the mutual energy of Scorpio and that person's spirit? I think both are kind of unhappy, because I think both are alone now, okay? Both are trying to manifest something that suits them, right? Both are trying to manifest their version of wish fulfillment. मे बी दिस पर्सन वॉन्ट्स समथिंग एल्स, दिस पर्सन वॉन्ट्स समथिंग एल्स, एंड गोल इज द सेम, राइट? बट बोथ पीपल वॉन्ट कंट्रोल इन हाउ दिस रिलेशनशिप शुड वर्क, गो फॉरवर्ड, राइट? आई डोंट थिंक आइदर ऑफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू टोटली कट ऑफ फ्रॉम ईच अदर ईदर. यू डोंट वॉन्ट दिस चैप्टर टू एंड वे यू नेवर सी ईच अदर अगेन. सो दैट्स वॉट यू ट्राइंग टू मैनिफेस्ट, समथिंग दैट वर्क्स फॉर बोथ ऑफ यू. But you both also have the nine of wands, okay, in your mutual energy. So both of you are kind of either fighting for it still, you know, or fighting each other. You both got your defenses up at the moment. So spirit, what is this nine of wands for Scorpio and that person? Four of swords. Right now, I don't think either of you are communicating with each other. Both of you trying to take a little time away. Both of you trying to keep your strength going and trying to understand what is the way that, you know, both can win in this dynamic. Because both of you want the same thing in different ways, I think. Yeah, so both, you know, I want to release all this stress and pain and tension between the two of you, and I'm wondering how is it possible that after all that's happened, how you both can come back, you know, and heal this hurt from the past, because I think both of you still have a lot of love for each other. Despite whatever happened, okay, some relationships are meant to be, some are not meant to be. Sometimes you have to, you know, go different paths to grow. The lessons that you have to learn from each other, and then you have to move on from that to, you know, maybe learn other lessons. So, but both of you do have a lot of love for each other. And yes, there was a lot of stability in the past, maybe. And this second week of June, around that time, you both are thinking about that. You're both thinking about the love that you shared, and you know, that home that you shared, probably. So what is the outcome, spirit? I'm a bit confused here, because you know, I don't see a reconciliation, but I do see love and affection and stability between the two of these two people. So are they going to come back together, spirit? Is there a chance of them reconciling? Come on, spirit, no suspense here. Please give us a card for the Ace of Cups and Four of Wands, which are just two beautiful cards to have as mutual energy. This is like love and security and everything. So can we expect this for Scorpio this time period? No, spirit doesn't want to say any. Ah, oh, finally. Both are trying to kind of find the courage, okay, to stand their ground without getting totally sucked into maybe a new beginning, but to keep the love going between the two of you. Let me take one more card. Both are trying to keep their version of what they want. They both agree that there is a lot of love. They both agree that this should have been. But both need different things, I think, now. Both have moved on to different things. The one person I do see wanting to come back. So, too many cards. Let's take one more. One more last card, spirit, please. Mutual energy. What can we expect for Scorpio? Nothing. Stalemate. Okay, both are being enlightened right now. Both are in hangman's position. Yes, they both love, you know, you both love each other. Both of you do want to get rid of all the past pain. Both of you are thinking about it. Both of you want to manifest a new beginning where both of you win, right? And both of you are trying your best not to totally complete the cycle. And both of you are trying to release all this self-inflicted pain and the stress that you both have been in. But I don't think either of you are, you know, bending down to the other either. Both are trying to keep their version of their life alive. So let's take an angel card for you, Scorpio, and see how this can work. So sweet. Okay, so spirit says, I think it's time to forgive each other, right? But also maintain your individuality, right? Separately. Because you have your own life which you have to lead, and so does the other, and you're both two powerful beings. Apart from that, you know, you also have to stay committed not only to the other person but also to yourself. To yourself, you know, because your first priority in life is yourself. So stay committed to this relationship, yes, if you can. Forgive each other of whatever you've done, and take charge of your own lives while being committed not only to the other person as much as you can, but also to yourself. So that's what I have for you, Scorpio. And if you see a little blue logo on your, you know, screen right now, click it and subscribe, please. It feels good to know you're out there listening. Or there's a little red button below as well, at, you know, you can click that. And I'll see you next week. Oops. Take care and be childlike. Have fun.